QuadJax World Series of Poker 2013. My name is Toby. It's my first time with QuadJax this summer. I hope you guys follow my interviews. And I'm very happy for my premiere show at QuadJax to be here with George Danzer. George Danzer is also very famous playing online on Scoop. He won the leaderboard this year. George, congratulations on this. Tell us a little bit about your World Series of Poker. What kind of events are you going to play?
Yeah, I'm this year chose to come over for 7 weeks. Last year I did only a small schedule, 3 weeks, just chose the best events. But this year I went to maximize the chance of winning a bracelet. So I came here early, choose a nice mixed game schedule, around 20 on tournaments, depending on how good I run. The better I run, the less tournaments. And just focusing really on the tournaments I'm really good at, not playing a lot of No Limit Hold'em events. Mm-hmm.
Have you played more No Limit Hold'em events in the past, and now you're adding, like, replacing No Limit Hold'em events with which games are your favorite ones?
Yeah, so I think I'm doing it since 3 or 4 years that I cut down on the No Limit Hold'em events. And first I started adding the Deuce to Seven. That was one of the first games I started on the mixed games. Then I added Omaha 8 or Better, which then got me into Pot Limit Omaha. So I'm playing the Pot Limit Omaha events too, and it all went from there. And now I play all the events, and my favorites are the 8 games, where you have a mixture of all those.
How about the average skill level? People play a lot No Limit these days. You can get coaching on TV, you can go to all these subscription sites. So an average players are getting better No Limit. How about those mixed games? Are they still so good to play that there's a lot of more value in them than in No Limit?
Yes, if you're really good at a mixed game, your value is much higher than a No Limit Hold'em event, because the average skill is way down in the mixed games. There isn't enough people who put the hours in and the training in to be good at Omaha 8 or Better, Stud 8 or Better. There are a few very good players, but usually those are the guys who are playing high-stakes cash games, so they're not even in those fields. And it depends a lot on the table you draw, so the luck involved is to get a nice starting table and have good tables throughout the tournament. But the average is much better than No Limit Hold'em events.
You are a very good player at the mixed games, George. Now, there are not so many videos and not so many strategy articles about these games out there online. So tell us a little bit about how you improve your game.
I mostly just think about what the strategy of the game should be. So you take the same approach as in No Limit Hold'em. You give your opponent some range. You think, how is he going to play that range and that range, and what's the best way to play against it? And then you just figure out which hands should you play, which hands should you play hard, which hands should you play slow, and just, it's game theory. And if you know how to play one game, you are going to figure out a way to learn the other games, even if you don't have a cheat sheet, like a good coach. Yeah, that's the best thing to have. You get a good coach, he's going to tell you a lot of things that you take forever to figure out yourself. But if you're a skilled No Limit Hold'em player, just think about it the same way and try to figure out, oh my, the better deuce to seven.
Do you have a coach, George?
I had coaches for the different games. I have No Limit Hold'em coaches now, so but for me it's the other way around. Uh-huh. But I coach, some of the other variations.
Who of the guys that are well known in America, who of the guys here that are good at mixed games would be good coaches?
Oh, I mean,
in other words,
probably they are not coaching. That's the problem, because they're. I mean, it takes a lot of time, and coaching is real work. So poker players, if they work, they want to grind and not teach other people how to beat them. So, there is a lot of good mixed games players. Like the players I have around the leaderboards all the time in the Scoop, players like Sean Deep, David Bakes, and Sean Buchanan, he's awesome. Dan Kelly is always up there. There's a lot of young young players that are not so well known in the No Limit Hold'em scene, but that they just crush the mixed games if you put them in those tournaments.
It sounds like you consider yourself already being old. No, you're not. How old are you, George?
I'm turning 30 this year. Oh. So for a poker player, I'm quite old.
Okay. George, one final word about the Scoop. It seems like the Scoop, the series on PokerStars, is like your home. It's like there. It's the place where you're most successful at, and you won the leaderboards, I think, twice. At least this year you won it.
This year I won two, the high and the overall leaderboard. Right. But I finished third, fourth and fifth a lot of the times. I was really getting angry.
It's like when I ask other players before the Scoop starts, like who's the favorite to win the overall leaderboard? Many players told me it's just George Danzer again. But as we know, poker is a game of luck as well and skill. And usually predictions will never, become reality. So what are you doing? Why is Scoop so special for you? Do you go with more confidence into the game? Why are you so successful there?
Yeah, it's just I like to grind when there is some constant pressure, and I just love leaderboards and points and trophies. And if there is a trophy up for grabs, I just can sit down for 2 weeks and start at 5 and end at 9 and then just sleep and play again the next day. And then in the morning, I look at the leaderboard, I see I'm fifth place, I need 60 more points, and I get the motivation from that to just continue grinding. And if it's just one tournament, like you have one EPT, okay, you go in there, you bust, it's over. You cannot get consistent number of tournaments in. So you don't even know how you're overall running or if you're a good player or not. Just by playing 10 EPTs and you haven't cashed, maybe you're still the best player in the field, right? But the Scoop is 130 tournaments. Mm. So you get a better idea of how consistent the players are. And I just play all of them, and then I just like to watch the points growing.
I guess everyone likes that, right?
Yeah, but for me it's more than the money, I'm not looking in there, okay, that's I want to win that much money. I played a lot of No Limit Hold'em events where I consider myself break even against the field, and it was 2,000 buy-in and more with rebuys and add-ons, and I couldn't sell percentages with markup or anything. I had to get a big piece of myself in those tournaments, but it was worth it because of the leaderboard too, so because I had a good chance. Mm-hmm. So I just said, I don't care if I'm losing a little money on this, I'm just going to barrel it into the No Limit Hold'em events, and it proved to be successful because I won one of the No Limit Hold'ems. Everything was perfect.
It worked out, right? And you have been on the right side of the very as well, I guess.
Yeah, it was really doing bad in No Limit Hold'em events. I mean, sounds like whining, it is probably, but I ran kings against aces, I couldn't count them, it was over 10 times in No Limit Hold'em events. Oh, okay. It was just kings against aces, and I was out of the tournament. Even a lot of the medium ones, where I usually go very deep a lot, in the 215 ones, and I didn't cash in one of those. Yeah, every time kings against aces, busto. Or I get fours in against two times ace king, busto. Stuff like that was just happening. And but at the end, it didn't matter because the one event where I ran over average because I was really getting ace king against ace queen, or I was flopping top pair a lot and people were stuffed the gut shot in there and my hand would hold up. So the variance in that tournament, everything came back. And then in the heads up, I flopped quads against aces, and I stuck it in with an open ender against top pair, and the open ender hits on the river. All that stuff came together in one tournament, and then it's perfect because the money is in the first three places. So if I just bust 10 tournaments, but for that all the luck comes together in the 11th one and I win it, it's worth it 10 times.
Great accomplishment, George Danzer. Thank you very much for this interview. That was Toby for Quadjax.com with my first interview. Stay tuned, guys. Bye bye.